Welcome back, Dark Souls fans, to another episode of Let's Die Horribly in Dark Souls 3. I'm your host, ShadowFury333, and we just, with some difficulty, beat a boss. Actually, beat a couple, kind of an optional boss, and then another optional boss. I don't want to waste my ember, but I'm so curious. Looks like a good way to die, though. I just want to kind of jump down there. Because, I mean, it's like, it almost looks like there's something there. Oh, well. Curiosity it is. Oh, that's actually non-fatal. All right, cool. Curiosity is rewarded. I figured it would be, because I remembered that ladder was there. Hooray for just... There it is!
You... Me, Bickleby... Me, Bumperum.
You're considerably less articulate than your fellows. I'm sorry. But what happens if I leave this stuff?
You. No.
What am I supposed to use rubbish for then? I was expecting when I found the crows, eventually, which I finally did, that I would be able to do that. Okay, well, maybe it's this. I mean, there's no smooth and silky stones.
Bumperum!
Hey! Okay, so is this a slot machine like in Dark Souls 1, or is this a... Oh. Well, this is interesting. Pickle pea or pump a rum? I don't know, sunlight metal? I mean, it seems like round objects, but... Well, at least it's not like in one. At least it's like in two, where you can just drop a thing and it works. If someone wants to tell me, go ahead. I'm not going to look it up. So, just so you know. Okay, I don't know. Maybe someone in the game will tell me. Like... Oh! Armor of the Sun?! Holy crap! Okay, well, there's the Solaire reference, so I was wondering when that would be. Chainmail armor and white coat featuring a large rendition of the holy symbol of the sun, the choice attire of a singular knight of sunlight from a previous age. The symbol was painted by the knight himself, but the armor never bore any special power, sacred or otherwise. Yeah, that is Solaire's armor. Solaire of Astora's armor. That is, I'm not just saying that because it looks like it. That was pretty much the description of Solaire's armor back in 1. And it's not as good. Alright. Wow, lots of knight armor really excels. Sheesh. I mean, granted, I'm in a situation where I can't really switch out my gloves to anything else, but still. What I can now. Aha! Aha! Brigand gauntlets! Alright, cool. So... That was kind of neat. I mean, I know, Dark Souls 1 reference, but it's not quite the same thing. I'm gonna forgive that one just for it being, well... One, kind of hard to get to, because I mean, if you think about it, I had to have not used Siegbrow. Well, I had to get the Siegbrow. Siegbrow. I had to not use Siegbrow. And I had to get... Oh. And I'd maintain it the entire game.
Very good.
Actually, let's just...
Very good. Oh. Very good.
What was I intending then?
Very good.
I don't know. Can't remember offhand. Anyway. No. Okay, so, well... Sheesh. So yeah, Siegfried's thing gets us... No. So my divine blessing right at the start of the game has been used up! But I got a... That was totally not worth it. The thing was like, okay, well, I got a jester, I guess? I guess that's for trading a lot, though.
Bumperum, bumperum. Bumperum, bumperum.
Titanite chunk? Sweet! I'm guessing I can only do that once, though. Yeah, that seems to be the way it goes. I might try her again later. But... Yeah. Is this large Titanite shards? Yeah, okay, that makes sense. So it's not a slot machine as far as I can tell, although it's hard to tell. And it seems like round objects do the trick. Okay, well, it looks like either large objects or slender, or round objects or slender objects. And that was neither. I don't know why I even thought that would be a good idea. Maybe these? Oh, Prism Stone, probably. Yeah, that'll do it too. Not Prism Stone, the... Oh. Another Dark Souls 1 reference. There's gonna be a lot of these. Oh, I can't drop Undead Hunter Charm? Well, Lloyd's Talisman, but yeah, Undead Hunter Charm? No. Drop the Dark Sign! Nope. Drop the Way of White Circle? Nope. I'm guessing Covenant items are not a thing I can use. I already tried Blood Red Moss Clump. Okay, so it's not slender or round. I'm guessing that's what it is. Although I can upgrade my Aerithal Straight Sword, which is nice. And also have a Titanite Chunk, although we'll need two, not one. So, yeah. That must be drop. Oh, I can't. What happens if I drop? This, I don't know, Chaos Gem. Okay, you know what, I'm done here. So that's pretty cool. So we got armor, which I'm probably not going to wear. Okay, I will wear it once just to see how it looks. Yep. That's Solaire's armor, all right. Well, Solaire's breastplate. Back to this one. It's not quite what I want. I want Elite Knight, which is blue, and this is red, although it's not bad. Is there anything else around here? Anything on the rooftops? Anything I can grab? Pick up, drop. Huh, okay, maybe not. Looks like no. Oh, there is! Okay, before I drop down from here, I do want to try one more thing. Yes, yes, thank you. Maybe Fading Souls have a bigger use than I thought. Nope, useless. Alright. Well, not totally useless, but, you know, not great. And what have you got? Homeward Bone. Oh, I didn't try that. That's slender. All right. One more. Exactly one more. And then we'll do more tower, because I want to know what the tower has. But hey, variety that's not just more smolder. Actually, at this point, I don't know where to go other than down in the smoldering lake. And the area I was at before, but whatever. Actually, can I? Okay. I'll check later if it's a matter of time or if it's a matter of reload the game. And if not... Yep, okay, that's what I thought. It's a slender object. What do I get for Homeward Bone? Iron bracelets! Actually, I have a feeling that a lot of this stuff is unique. I mean, Solaire's... Unless it's like... You get... Every time you get Zigbro, you then use Solaire's... You get different parts of Solaire's armor? I don't know. Oh, no, this is another part of Solaire's armor. And it's worse than what I have in literally every way except for magic and fire resistance. And it's only slightly better, and dark. And it's only slightly better, actually it's... No, it's very, very slightly better, and it's heavier! So, no. Alright. So I'm guessing I'll be able to get Solaire's little rust bucket and leggings. And that'll be it. But yeah, okay. There we go, that's a thing. Surprisingly enough, humanity does not... I mean, Ember does not give anything. I would think it'd be kind of slender. But apparently it is insufficiently slender for the likes of whoever that is pickle pump. I don't know. Oh boy. No reason to go down there without full health. As I say before, I go straight up. I'm gonna guess this is like the other area I was in where you can go down or you can go up, but I want to know what's up here. Lyra, oh, is there patches? Is this where the patches is? Because every FromSoft game, not just Dark Souls, not just Bloodborne, every FromSoft game has a patches, apparently. So I'm not sure if the Armored Core one was not as sneaky, but yeah, there's, you know, a sneaky... Oh, I think I know what's going on. My guess is I'll find patches in the field somewhere, and then they'll be up here. Because patches, in Dark Souls at least, likes to put themselves in really precarious areas, rather than safe areas that you can just sort of go to. But no, they have got to be in precarious areas. Is that the Bell of Awakening? And a Firekeeper Soul. I bet I could trade that to Snuggly. I mean, whatever it's called. Pickle pea. Let's call it pickle pea for now. I don't know what the crow is called. What am I, a strategy guide? Let's read the Firekeeper Soul description. Oh, it's a key item, so there's no dropping it. Soul of a Firekeeper who is said to have returned from the Abyss. This Firekeeper preserves a bonfire and serves its champion. She is said to have soothed and accepted the dark sigil which has tainted her soul. And yet, her soul will one day embed itself in the bosom of another Firekeeper. So, either the one that gives me levels, or Irina of Karim. Whoa! Yay! We have the thing again where you can look at the world and you see parts of the world! There's the Eudex Gundyr boss fight, and there's where I was right before the Eudex Gundyr boss fight, and there's the little castle area that I started in that I can't really explore beyond where I was at this point, as far as I know, unless I'm wrong, and actually I missed a secret area that I can go to that allows me to go backwards into the castle back there, which would be really cool, but I don't know if that connects to anything else, although I imagine it might actually connect to Lothric. Maybe. I mean, I teleported there in the first place, so I actually have no idea how this connects to the rest of the world. All I know is there's a castle here. And I don't know how to get to it. And we're on a mountain somewhere. Alright, let's go down. Preferably without dying. So, as I'm going through this, I'm expecting the way this works is like in the Undead Settlement, where we first found Siegfried. And I'd be wrong! I would be very wrong. In fact, I would be embarrassingly wrong, but I could live or back. To get that back. You've got to be kidding me. Oh boy. Oh wait. Hang on. $15,000 souls. Shit. Okay, who the hell wrote there? Also, do I want to talk to you about this thing?
Welcome home, speak. Farewell, men.
Do I want to give Irina this? Can I give Irina this thing? Before I give it to anyone else. I mean, my buddy Irina here. Maybe she'd use it. I don't know.
Oh, champion, do you wish?
Nope.
You know, I would, but if I are terrible. Have
that's fine. Just want to make sure that you didn't need the Firekeeper Soul for any reason. But the Firekeeper does. What does the Firekeeper do with the Firekeeper Soul?
Welcome
what do you
home,
do?
Speak.
I guess.
Ashen One, this is much like what lies within me.
Well, it seems like it belongs better to you.
Its own place within my bosom. She will understand. We are both fire keepers after all.
Oh!
Forgive me, may the... Ashen one, soft, I was ashen.
Oh wait, what am I doing? I'm asking you to level up. I don't have any souls on hand.
Farewell, Ashen.
Let's pick up the ones that I dropped, alright? Let's just do that. Okay, so that's a thing. But I don't know. I know I said, oh, come on, please give me a thing that allows me to heal my soul corruption stuff. But I've been kind of told that I don't want to do that. I haven't been really told exactly why. I've just been told that hollowing's not a big deal and you actually don't lose anything, but you gain something and you don't want to heal it if you don't have to. And I mean, I have a way of looking human, so yeah. I won't worry about it. That's cool. Alright, let's pick up my souls. Hopefully. They're not out in the abyss, are they? No, good, okay. Alright, so... that was a mistake. I'm guessing the intended path is over here. And now I guess down here? Ow. And then there, and then down here. Ow. Estus ring, huh? And the area behind the master. Okay, finally come full circle. Open that up. What am I missing in here? Can't see a thing. Oh. No, that's the master. Alright. Well, let's see what the Estus Ring does. The Estus Ring increases HP restored by the Estus Flask. A green ring crashes from shards. This ring was entrusted to a certain firekeeper, but in the end she never met her champion, and the ensuing tragic farce became a favorite tale of the masses. That's cold. Alright, so cool. So I can basically heal more with that ring. That's good to know. I mean, right now it's not my biggest problem. My biggest problem is... okay, I guess I have to jump to there. I am suicidally curious about what's over there. I believe we may be having a death montage! That or I'll get to the next go and then we won't have a death montage. But we might! As soon as I found it... oh, what the heck? Did I seriously miss that behind the zombie dog? Hey, I one-shot zombie dogs now! Nice! Hank Wood's shield. Who's Hank Wood? Shield that belonged to Hank Wood, a deserter from the Undead Legion. The unique swordsmanship of the Watchers does not normally allow for the use of shields. The unique swordsmanship of the Watchers would not allow such a shield, and Hank Wood's very possession of it was telltale of his defeat. Yeah, come on. Shields? What the hell, man? You should know better than to use shields. We shieldless stick together, except you, traitor. Traitor to the shieldless cause. Which I'm not saying with enough sarcasm or irony, because, yeah, obviously it's hard. It's probably a lot easier to have a shield just because you don't have to react to things as much, which, as I mentioned during the boss fights in the last episode, Dark Souls 3 is not super well built to allow for Twitch reactions. Like, it's not super meant for that, but it's not even so much meant or not meant. It's like, it's the simple fact of, oh, come on! All right, death montage starts here, I guess. Well, okay, short death montage. Firekeeper stuff! And a skirt, which might be better than my current skirt. Back to the shrine! Alright, so no actual death montage, just a cut. But whatever, that's fine. So, what's this stuff both say and do? robe worn by the guardian of the shrine, the firekeepers were robbed of light to better serve as vessels for souls. Only those who cherish the writhing, searing darkness were given the keeper's black attire. Actually, how weak is this? Oh, super light, way less absorption. What about compared to the skirt? Way better absorption, and it's the same weight too, or slightly better absorption, not way better. Actually, I don't know, versus strike is considerably better. I like how this looks. I mean, is it blue? No, that's more for black. I mean, ultimately I want the dingy skirt, but this will do in a pinch. I mean, the dingy skirt was a firekeeper skirt. Actually, how does it look if I put on, which one was it? You know what, that's not bad of the mirror vest. Not a big fan of the sandals though. That's some fashion souls. Although this is definitely a fashion is pain situation because, wow, my absorption's bad. I don't have my hat. No, not what I want. Wait, what? When did I get this? Attire of pyromancers of the Great Swamp, particularly favored by old sages. The large blindfold blocks out unnecessary light, allowing one to observe pyromancy's true essence. The flame reveals all and obscures all. Okay, I guess I didn't get anything from the firekeeper for that. That was a little bit higher. It'd be like a sorcerer's stuff. Actually, what a nameless knight's armor on this. It's not terrible. Not elite knight's armor, though. Oops, no! My best gauntlets! Okay, well, fallen knight armor doesn't look great. Actually, how does this look with this skirt? It's still pretty bad. It's not as obvious as the white skirt, but it's still pretty bad. Gotta say, the fallen knight armor with the fallen knight trousers, just for demonstration purposes, man, it looks like that is straight out of Bloodborne. That looks like German stuff. Whatever, firekeeper robe, firekeeper thing, red stuff. I know, I'm being very erudite right now. Where was I looking? Oh yeah, firekeeper gloves, which I don't really care about. Does it say anything more here? No. They just wrap the hands, I assume. Yeah, they just wrap the hands. Don't want to go full firekeeper. Not trying to do a firekeeper cosplay here. Okay. That's too heavy, that's too heavy, that's with intolerance. That's bringing gauntlets to the best one. Okay. Alright, cool. So, we have a slightly better getup, I think. And it's more defensive, too. Except for the lack of a hat. If we get a sorcerer's hat or another kind of like Balmoral cap type thing, I am totally going to wear that. I'm going to wear the hell out of that. Don't have that yet. Okay, I'm just going to do... Actually, what am I doing farming? I was going to say I was doing a teeny tiny bit of farming. I have a bunch of other stuff to do. I'm not going to do farming, but I will cut. So, be back in a sec. Alright, well, we're back. Welcome back, Dark Souls 3 fans, and we have more Smoldering Lake and Sandworms. All the sandworms. I also upgraded my longsword, and it turns out my... Urethel Straightsword is totally outclassed at this point. Like, there is just no way it's going to be worth using. Which is kind of sad, but yeah. Like, unless maybe I got enough Twinkling Titan to bring it up to plus 5, maybe. But yeah, the longsword just outdoes it. Ah! Ah. Okay, so I know it stops here. Can I even hit this thing? Not fruitfully! You know, I'm just gonna assume that the sandworm is where the sandworm is always, so That's probably a waste of time. I mean, this is a... not this, but the Demon Ruins bonfire is a better run back to where I wanted to go originally, so there's that, I guess. It's not much run back, honestly. It doesn't improve it much. It improves it slightly. Like, ridiculously slightly, in fact. I don't even know if I'd say it improves it at all, honestly, but... technically it does, I think, maybe barely improve it? Maybe? I don't have to fall. That's kind of the key thing there. I mean, I do have to fall at some point. Wait, what's up here? Oh, wait a sec. This is where all the... yeah, this is where these guys are. All right, nothing of any real value here. Let's go back down to where I was going to go originally, which was that big pit that I tend to die to go into, which I will again this time around. Yeah! Oh, seriously? Stupid rats. Wow, relentless. Alright, so now I know where to go. Now I know where to go. I still think this is a better run back. I don't have to drop into the fire as much. I can just sort of run, and then run, and then run some more, and then not die, hopefully, and then run! Because I just go down the stairs... and then I turn left, grab my souls. And then drop and claymore and then roll. Ow. I can't, oh wait, no, I just run, don't I? I just run through the basilisks. Run! Eventually I'll lose them. The basilisks won't hurt me. They'll just curse me. They'll either kill me or they won't do anything. I admire your determination, basilisk, but nope. See ya. Okay, well, I gotta be honest. I had a break. I mean, what? You respawn? What is this? I rolled. What? No! Ah, shoot. You've gotta be kidding me. I got a gesture for that? Also, you've got to be kidding me. The Black Knight respawns? That is not good. It's good practice, I suppose. But I'd say overall, that's not good. I'll cut to when I get back there. Will I end you, Black Knight? Ah! No, I will not. I can never get the spacing right on that one. I keep thinking I'm going to move far enough away that it won't matter. Man, you're annoying, jerk rat. You're also dead. As all good jerk rats should. Okay, who's at the bottom? I don't have very many souls at the top, so I don't really care. Who's at the bottom? That's a jerk at the bottom. Although they gave me a gesture, so... Wow. Do you respawn? Because everyone respawns. Oh. Torg. Everyone respawns in this game. Except for like two Black Knights. But not the one up there. For some reason that does respawn. I am so lost. I probably missed a turn somewhere where that doll would be. Because, I mean, as far as I know, I've been going in relatively straight lines this entire time. Oh, for crying out loud, let me through. As far as I'm aware, I have not had much in the way of path deviation. The only places I can think of offhand are some of the lower areas in, like, I can't even remember where. Nah, no, get away from me. Great. Ah. Must you ex- not again? Not what I wanted. This run back is such a pain, but I don't know where else I can go. The problem. Like, as far as I know, I don't have any other options. This is it. This is the only place left in the game that I'm actually capable of going to. At least taking the obvious routes of, well, beat the bosses. Actually, even this wasn't an obvious route. This is a, like, down a bridge that you didn't actually have to break. As far as I know, that Fire Demon boss that I had to beat to get here was optional, or boss in quotes, because it's not really a boss so much. It was a big enemy. It was kind of an optional boss, but I guess, I mean, I don't know. Why are you all of a sudden chasing after me? What the heck changed? Whatever, you can die. Now I want to deal with that other thing. That Night Slayer Tzorig. Yes, I know, but who else am I going to fight? A tough enemy. I have two tough enemies to fight. Although both of them can be backstabbed. Oh, right, because you can block with the two-handed sword. What? I must be missing something. There must be another path. As far as I can tell, all I have left to do here is a couple optional things. Like, that's it. That's all I've got left, as far as I know, is a couple optional things. Not including the Black Knight, whatever lies beyond. Because I killed the boss. Wait, what's that? Hang on. What's that past the sandworms? Ah! Must everything be opposed to me? No, I'm back to hating this area. I don't get this area at all. Mostly because it's like, I don't know where to go. But I feel like I'm trapped here because I don't know any other areas that are open to me. Like, what areas are open to me? There's this. And that's about it. Okay, whatever. Ah, stupid great arrows. The only reason I'm even running with any hope at all is that it looks like there's something over here. But that might have been where I came in. In fact, I think it's where I came in. Actually, given that that's where the sandworms are, this is where I came in. Oh, for crying out loud! This is just where I came in. Oh, come on, trees, give me cover or something. Well, maybe it's over here somewhere. I don't know. Two, three. Okay, let's go. Cave with a Titanite lizard. And more twinkling. Not that I really need it right now, because the Earthhill Straight Sword doesn't seem to be super strong, but maybe I'll find enough. Where's the trap? No, get back here. Get back here. Darn it. I'm not gonna reload the game yet. This is another optional boss, isn't it? Well, more large titanite shards at least. Wait a sec. I know this area. This is where the stuff drops to. I was actually wondering what this crap was. Oh, I guess skeletons drop down here and then you die. I guess. This isn't progress. Just to point that out, game. I mean, okay, cool, I got some titanite, which is handy. I will admit, I do need one more in order to be able to upgrade something, but okay, give you that. Doesn't do me much good, though. Oh yeah, that's the corpse. Ay. So, okay. That was a neat diversion. That was three, so I can continue moving. And giant enemy crabs. All right. That does me no good. So we have the crabs, which I don't think is any items near it that I haven't explored yet. We have the sandworms by the boss. Ow. That was undercover. And that's about it. So I'm stuck. I'm well and truly stuck. Actually, maybe I'm not. Maybe this could lead somewhere. Maybe. Nope, I'm stuck. This does not lead anywhere. That just makes you see that there's the place with the boss and the sandworms and no other real benefits. So this is essentially, as far as I can tell, an optional area for getting a bunch of additional titanite and a bunch of additional other items. Mostly titanite. And otherwise doesn't provide too much. Did I miss anything along here that I could go with? Well, I don't know. Maybe if I go back here. Shoot, there might be a doll back here. I don't know. There wasn't the first game. Like really, if you go straight back to where you started in the entire game, in game one, which is a bit tricky to do, but if you do, remember me, then you get a doll. I believe I actually talked about this already. Trivial. Anyway. Is it over? Oh, there's an item here. Nope. Soul of a deserted corpse. Okay. Probably could have gotten that right out of the gate rather than 32 episodes in, but whatever. And that's my help start stuff. That there's nothing I can do here. And there's that giant castle I don't know about. Well, this looks familiar. Although I wonder what's past that giant titanite lizard. Oh, would you die? Well, okay, this is kind of being a waste, but whatever. What I want to know is that big titanite lizard in the area past it. Is there an area past it? Did I miss something? I remember I was actually trying to find secret areas here before. I wasn't sure whether or not secret areas were acquired by swinging or by hitting the action button. fairly certain it's by swinging. And as far as I can tell, there's no real way to get up to the castle area through a secret area, hypothetically. Shoot. Or is it a jumped place? I don't know. I mean, this is not really stuff that you'd have to go back to. I mean, in Dark Souls 1, I talk a lot about how you go back to the starting area, but in 1, in order to go back to the starting area, you have to go through about 15% of the game. Like, you have to. You have to get to one of the bosses that you have to beat in order to beat the game. You don't have to have beaten it, but you have to get to that area. And then you... Oh, for crying out loud. And then you can go back to your starting area, and it's a lot harder. This is just a warp. It's not really anything to it. Unless this is meant to be an optional area that you could do right at level 1, but I don't know. It looks like no. Great. I am thoroughly lost. Alright, well, whatever. I'm just going to end it here, I guess. And then I will pick it up wherever I happen to find that there's new stuff. Maybe it's here. I doubt it.